Okay, from the intro, let's do it.
Let's figure out those little transitions. Boom, 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 ba dum, ba da 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 da. Motown, Philly Soul, Memphis, Stax, Volt, all that music was the music of kind of my youth. Before I ever saw Zeppelin or any of those people, I was lucky enough to see Otis Redding. I saw Solomon Burke. That really is part of the foundation of what I do.
Do you remember when you used to say, we'll stay together?
Everybody knows Paul as the founder, co-founder of Kiss, but they don't know him outside of that.
To come out and do a Motown project, a soul music project, is definitely a change, but he's incredible at it.
Every day I pray you're coming back to stay, but till my dreams come, then we go, but till my dreams come true.
I'll never forget when Paul first sent me the song list, and I literally emailed him back and said, I think you sent me the wrong songs. These are Motown songs. And he said, no, these are the right songs.
Every day I pray you're coming back.
It's a very different thing to be paying homage to someone else's music. And understandably, people are surprised when they think of me doing it. You know, I've also done Phantom of the Opera. I'm not on a crusade. I'm not the spokesman or the flag bearer for rock and roll or metal or blues rock or whatever. I play music. I sing. That's what I do.
Okay, nice.
It's amazing that Paul has taken the initiative to do these songs with such integrity. The songs are so dead on and so accurate. I told him the shock value is a bit creepy almost. It sounds so much like Motown.
There's a spirit to not only Motown, but to Philly soul. There's an emotional quality, and to have that surrounded by strings and horns makes it glorious. It makes it almost heroic.
Woo-hoo! Did you get that last F on the one?
Today, we've been recording one of Paul's original songs named I Do.
I do.
What I love about this is based on a dialogue where ideas are taken, valued, and expressed.
Yeah, go ahead.
We're doubling that?
We're doubling that, yeah. Let's double this ending, guys.
And the musicians that make this band, some of the greatest guys around, are willing to partake in this dialogue with the most important characteristic that any dialogue has, listening.
So the very last bar has F minor, G minor, A flat, and B flat, all triads.
Hence, the ability to unfold something where everyone is involved. And that's the beauty of this project. We recorded a rhythm section first to make sure we had the foundation, you know, and the right direction that Paul desired.
If you took a drummer out of a quote-unquote metal band, it would be a disaster. Eric is an incredible, incredible drummer. He played in big bands with his dad. His background is really immense.
I try to always have a very, very open mind. As long as it works for the song, I'll try anything, I'll play it.
So we go... Because when you mark one, we just hit the end of four.
That makes sense.
That makes a lot of sense. Bravo.
These guys, these are what we call like yo cats. These guys can literally come in, listen to something, write it out, make a chart. I have to put the extra work in. I feel like I owe it to myself and to them to come in really prepared. Mainly I do that out of respect to everybody else, because my idea is that I'm here to make the song better, be a team player, and, you know, leave your ego at the door, I always say.
Then we brought in the horns. These are the guys that we usually use on the road when we travel, especially John Pappenbrook. He actually worked for Frank Sinatra, worked for everybody. So, you know, it's great to have somebody with that kind of experience.
Here's what we're gonna do. Three bars, take a breath. Half notes, three bars.
Yep. So many times in sessions and recordings nowadays, they throw the music in front of you. They want it played exactly the way it is on the page. They don't care about interpretation. Paul and Alex, they give us a guide track and we morph the guide track into the final product. And that's old school. And I dig it. I like it.
That works, huh?
Yeah.
Then we did the strings.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Now we're getting ready to record vocals.
Could yes. Okay. Yes, yes.
I was living in a dream. Can we start from the top one more
yep.
time? And remember, guys, we sing that line with him in right. harmony, okay. and then this in harmony. When you're performing this kind of music, you just really have to share who you are and your feelings. You can feel when somebody is just singing, opposed to when somebody's going through something.
I do.
This is my favorite time, and when we get together and we're recording or we're performing, we just have so much fun together.
She is nobody's backup singer. For me to think that anybody's backing me up is ridiculous.
I honestly, this is the reason why I love working with this man.
The incredible thing about any art is you take something intangible and make it tangible. So you come up with something and then you bring it to fruition. So to write a song, to hear it in your head, to work out an arrangement, come into the studio and build and go, yeah, this is what I envisioned. And to do it in the company that I'm doing it in is incredible. My life is about why not. My life has nothing to do with why. You know, my nose is in front of me, I follow it.
They say my broken heart will surely mend, but there's no pretending this place.